Very good morning to all of you. For today, electronic circuit topic, we are going to cover the breakdown mechanism. As we see, breakdown mechanism is only occur in reverse biasing. And there are two types of breakdown mechanisms. One is your Zener breakdown, another one is avalanche breakdown. Okay, so avalanche and Zener breakdown are two different mechanisms by which a PN junction breaks. PN junction means the connection of the combination of p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. Okay, but remember, it always occur in reverse biasing. Second is, both occur under reverse bias. The main difference between the Zener breakdown and the avalanche is their mechanism of occurrence, that how they occur, what is the procedure behind their occurrence. Okay, next is, Zener breakdown occurs because of the high electric field, whereas avalanche occur because of the collision of free electrons with atoms. So when we talk about the Zener breakdown, it always occur because of high electric field. And when we talk about the avalanche breakdown, it will cause because of the collision of free electrons present in your semiconductor. This is a major difference between Zener and avalanche. This is how it occurs, okay? Both these can occur simultaneously if we have to use both the mechanism in a single device. Yes, we can use it, okay? The basic comparison between avalanche breakdown and the Zener breakdown is, first is definition. The avalanche breakdown is a phenomenon of increasing the free electrons or electric current in semiconductors and insulating by applying the higher voltage. But in case of Zener breakdown, the process in which the electrons are moving across the barrier from the valence band of the p-type material to the conduction band of the lightly filled n material is known as Zener breakdown. So these are the simple definitions of the avalanche breakdown and the Zener breakdown. Okay. The next point is, the major difference is depletion region. When we talk about the avalanche breakdown, the depletion region is thick, but when we talk about the Zener breakdown, the depletion region is thin. In case of junction, the junction will completely destroy, and in this case, it is not completely destroyed. Partially, the junction is present. Electric field, it has a very weak electric field and it has a very strong electric field because the main conductivity will take place because of electric field in Zener breakdown. Procedures, pair of electrons and holes. The procedure will take place because of pair of holes and electrons. And in this, the procedure will take because of electrons only whenever the conductivity take place because of electrons. Doping. Doping means the impurity factor we are adding. It has a very low impurity factor and it has very heavy impurity factor added in this. Reverse potential. It has very high potential, reverse potential, and it has very low potential. Temperature coefficient. Temperature coefficient in this case is always positive and in this case is always negative. If we talk about the next step, that is ionization. It is because of collision of holes or of electrons. It is because of electric field. Okay, breakdown voltage directly proportional to the temperature, inversely proportional to the temperature. So this is the major comparison and the difference between your Zener and avalanche breakdown. There is a graph also, graphical representation. So this is the graphical representation of both the breakdowns. As we see, the breakdown will occur only in reverse condition. Okay, so as you see in the diagram. And avalanche, this is the Zener breakdown and this is the avalanche. We can say also that in Zener breakdown, there is a very sharp cut. But here we are showing in gradual way, but it is a very sharp cut available here. Okay, so I hope you understand the topic. Thank you very much.